10 दिन के अंदर लोन प्रोसेस किया, मोर सो मैंने शिफ्टेड फ्रॉम पीएनबी फॉर सम एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव रीजंस। और उसके बाद माई फर्स्ट केस सिडबी वर्किंग कैपिटल नहीं देता। आई टोल्ड दी मैनेजर्स ओवर देयर कि मैं एक बैंक एक काम के लिए आपके पास, दूसरे के लिए पीएनबी के पास नहीं जाऊंगा। माइन वाज द फर्स्ट केस विच प्रोसेस्ड एंड वर्किंग कैपिटल लोन ऑफ 1 करोड़ रुपीज वाज गिवन टू मी। कुछ भी नहीं था मैनी साहब, ओनली ए विजिट बाय योर डीजीएम एंड द मैनेजर प्लस हिज यूनिट। सिंपल सी एप्लीकेशन थी, आई डिड नॉट गेट एनी सीए आल्सो विद मी। और उन्होंने मेरा केस किया और आज मैं मतलब आई एम गेटिंग ऑल द फैसिलिटीज। द पीपल हैव चेंज्ड बट आई अप्रिशिएट द माइंडसेट व्हिच यू हैव इंकल्केटेड इन द माइंड्स ऑफ योर मैनेजर्स और द डेप्टी मैनेजर।
नहीं नहीं, इसमें हम वही बता रहे, माइंडसेट जो है उदाहरण की वजह से बोले, क्लस्टर का जो एडवांटेज है ना, जो क्लस्टर का जो एडवांटेज हो, जब सब लोग वहां पे हैं
सर, क्लस्टर और नो क्लस्टर सर,
उसका फर्क पड़ता
है। क्लस्टर और नो क्लस्टर, स्मॉल स्केल में छोटी प्रॉब्लम सर ये है कि हमारे पास इतना डाटा नहीं होता। एक बार आपकी ऐसे यूनिट से जिनके पास बैलेंस शीट ही 4-5 साल नहीं बनती जी, जो इन्फॉर्मेशन बैंक मांगते हैं वो नहीं दे सकते हम। अगर थोड़ा सा हम खुद कुछ कर ले तो मेरा ख्याल है कि सिडबी हैज़ ए रोल टू प्ले एंड इज गोइंग टू प्ले कंस्ट्रक्टिवली दैट रोल, और दे आर इंटरेस्टेड फॉर, दैट्स व्हाई इट इज डिराइव्ड द नेम स्मॉल इंडस्ट्रियल डेवलपमेंट बैंक ऑफ इंडिया। दे आर सपोज टू डू दिस जॉब, दिस इज प्राइवेट जॉब एंड दे आर। सर
थैंक यू सर।
एक बार सर, रेट ऑफ
मे आई, ओके,
इन 15% टू पीएनबी प्रोसेस केस है, यू कैन सी माई डॉक्यूमेंट्स, सिडबी इज चार्ज मी 12.5, आई हैड ए रिसेंट मीटिंग विद देम, दे आर कमिटेड टू लोअर इट बाय 0.25%।
थैंक यू
सर। आई एग्री दैट द क्लस्टर्स वुड बी अ गुड आइडिया, बट एवरीबडी ओवरनाइट कैनॉट बी इन अ क्लस्टर। सपोज इंडिविजुअल कंपनीज, द वेल ऑर्गेनाइज्ड स्मॉल सेक्टर, दे मेक द बैलेंस शीट, द इनकम टैक्स, एवरीथिंग इन ऑर्डर, देन हाउ लॉन्ग डज इट टेक टू अप्लाई टू एस डी सिडबी एंड गेट द लोन?
मिस्टर मैनी,
लेट मी फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल क्लैरिफाई, टू द बेस्ट ऑफ माई अंडरस्टैंडिंग, MSMEs विच आर वेल ऑर्गेनाइज, विच हैव वेल डॉक्यूमेंटेड बैलेंस शीट्स एक्सेट्रा, I don't think that they really face a problem in the banking sector. It is those MSMEs where the information asymmetry exists, where there is lack of transparency, that the problem comes in. You're talking about a well-organized MSME.
Private,
how long would it take to take it to get financing, even if it's outside a cluster? Cluster was very relevant from the point of view of competitiveness, as he said, from the point of view of facilitating various schemes from banks like the one I mentioned, which makes it very easy for banks to finance. But an individual standalone unit, which meets all the requirements of a bank and is a creditworthy unit, there would be absolutely no hesitation in the banks financing such a unit. Just to mention a figure, last year, the MSME credit growth from the banking sector was over 28%, as against a normal credit growth of just about 15 to 16%. He mentioned earlier also that MSME credit has been growing 20% year on year. And today the MSE, micro and small enterprise credit from the banking sector, stands at about 6.5 trillion rupees. That is the amount of credit which has gone to these units. Coming to your specific question, how many days it takes? Every bank, every institution has its own specific procedure. But from receipt of a completed application, we say 30 days is the time limit for sanction.
Okay, okay. My next question is that, do software companies also get supported by SIDBI?
I think today is my day. Well, let me answer that also. And again, it's a very interesting question. I mentioned earlier also that the requirements of service sector vis-a-vis the manufacturing sector are very different. The manufacturing sector, in a way, is able to offer tangible security in terms of its land, building, plant and machinery to the banking industry. And so based even on the primary security, many manufacturing sector projects can get financed. In the services sector, you operate normally from leased premises. You don't have a tangible security of machinery also. It's only the software which is a security. Now, how do you finance such units? We have in SIDBI set up a specialized vertical called the services sector vertical, which has come out with specialized cash flow based products to finance the services sector. Coming specifically to the software sector, let me say that we had a meeting with NASSCOM about a year ago. NASSCOM is the Association of Software Companies, all of you would know. Right. Now, NASSCOM told us that there are about 1,500 odd members approximately who are in the MSME space in NASSCOM, and maybe not more than 50 to 100 of them have access to bank funding. Though they are into branded software, many of them are exporting their software also, and many of these companies are in the range of 5 to 50 crores kind of turnovers also. And yet they are not getting funding for the simple reason that there was no security. Now, we entered into an MOU with NASSCOM, whereby we said that as a banker, let me be very, very honest, I don't understand software, I don't understand technology, and I don't have the bandwidth to understand a variety of softwares and technologies, obviously. So this is where NASSCOM, again an example of an industry association coming forward, would vet the technology and the potential of that company for us in terms of its market, basically. We would sit down with NASSCOM and assess the promoters together, and then decide on financing, and financing up to 1 crore of rupees would be covered under the Credit Guarantee Trust for Micro and Small Enterprises, which covers all loans which are given without collateral security and third party guarantee. Under this MOU, the first two or three cases have been kicked off recently, have been sanctioned, and we expect that based on the experience, this model would get scaled up. And again, it's a scalable model with the backing of an industry association, which is why I keep coming back to the emerging role of associations, which is going beyond the traditional lobbying role with the government towards empowering their members.